everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Well guys, today we're going to customize more dolls, of course, because this is what we're doing here in my studio. And today I thought we would make a Tinkerbell doll, because yeah, you asked me already many times to make one, and I really love this character personally. I haven't watched all the spin-offs. I know that Disney have really lots of different, I don't know, shows and films and everything about Tinkerbell and her friends. For me, Tinkerbell is still the character from the original Peter Pan movie, and I really loved her as a kid, and I still love her. For me, this is such a, I don't know, bright, funny, very cartoonish and kind of summer related character. And I don't know, I'm just in a, such a good mood today. The weather is good, it's hot, it's real summer. I'm getting my first shot tomorrow, so I don't know, I'm just in a very good mood, and I feel like making a super cute, super colorful, bright, cartoonish and summerish Tinkerbell. So this is the goal for today. My mom is helping me with the outfit. I have planned lots of different accessories. I have quite special vision, I think, about this character. So let's start working, because I'm really excited. I want to like share my good mood, my good energy today with you. So let's make this doll, guys. Of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, because I've heard lately that some people don't get notified about my new uploads, so check it please. I don't know, it's quite important. And of course, support my art on YouTube with your likes, because it really helps me to reach new people, to grow my audience. And now let's start working, guys. So this is the model for our Tinkerbell makeover. I think Draculaura has just the perfect face to become a Disney fairy. All the features are quite spot on here. So let's remove all these clothes and hair, everything that she has now, because you know that every doll makeover starts with getting a clean canvas. The old trick with warming up the doll head with a hair dryer to make it soft and easily removable, and also to melt the glue inside of the head, you know, it's still kicking in after all these years. And also pure acetone never fails to do its job. So now everything is gone and we can create our own doll out of this Draculaura. I'm going to start with her hair, and after recovering her head with a couple of layers of light acrylics, I take my rerouting tool, this self-made rerouting tool made out of an X-Acto knife and out of an embroidery needle with a loop cut open, and I give this doll new blonde hair. And this is the end result a couple of hours later, and yes guys, we're going to make bangs again today. You know how much I like doing it on rerouted hair, but there is nothing to do, I need to master this skill, and maybe I will even love it one day. So, and for now I let the glue dry, I spray her face with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then I will start drawing. You see, there is some serious staining on her face, but I really hope I will be able to cover it up using just soft pastels. Let's see what my favorite pan pastels are capable of in this situation. So check it out, it's become almost invisible already after just one layer. You can clearly see the difference already now. But let's still apply the second layer and see what it gives. And the staining is gone, I guess. Yeah, I don't know, it was even easier than I thought. I expected to use three layers, but two were already more than enough. So now we can start sketching her face with watercolor pencils. And then I will apply a little bit darker pastels to make shadows and then some blush, like always, like working on her skin tone. And when I feel completely satisfied with her skin tone, I can start drawing everything more detailed and add more color to her face. Tinkerbell has blue eyes, and I hope there is no controversy about this, because I don't know if you have seen my post about the real conspiracy regarding the color of Aurora's eyes, but I thought it was very interesting, so I wanted to share it with you again now. So, when I was reading the comments under my last video, the Sleeping Beauty doll makeover, I could see that quite a big part of people got really upset about the blue color of my Aurora's doll's eyes. Okay, maybe not upset, but many people were quite unpleasant, surprised, like, why did I give my Aurora doll the blue eyes? But what was really interesting, that one half of the people were upset about her eyes being blue and not purple, because, you know, her eyes in the movie were purple, people have seen it themselves, it's a fact, and another half was upset about her eyes being not black or dark brown, also because this is how they have seen it in the movie. So, you know, it threw me a little bit in the loop, because I was sure about her eyes being blue, and the fact is, they sold us three different Aurora eye colors in the same movie and nobody noticed. Like, okay, not nobody, actually a lot of people did notice it, because there are a lot of articles, forum discussions and even videos on YouTube trying to solve the mystery, talking about it. The fact is that you can see all the variations of her eye color in the movie, and for my doll I've decided to go for a blue color, because the close-up in the moment when Aurora opens her eyes, awakening from her dream, from her sleep, it clearly shows her with bright blue eyes. The black eyes she has when we see her a little bit more from far, they just didn't draw the irises very detailed, it's a little bit like simplification. And there are two main theories regarding the purple eyes, and both of them sound legit to me. The first version is that this is also just how they showed the blue eyes in a more dark environment, they just used purple to show shadowing on her blue eyes. Or there is also another version that her eyes are purple when she gets cursed. So, and when the curse is released, when the prince kisses her, she gets her blue eyes back. Also, I don't know, possible, both of these theories make sense to me. So I thought it was a very interesting discovery and I really wanted to share it with you, but I don't know, it looks like there is no controversy regarding Tinkerbell's eyes. She has blue eyes. Okay, this is it, the face is done. Now let's quickly blush her body and then we'll move on to some more exciting things, like making her outfit, for example. So my mom is helping me with this project today and now you can see her making the iconic green leaf dress. And this is actually a very simple dress, I don't mean like simple to make, but it doesn't look that complicated nor sophisticated. We have an underskirt with a zigzag bottom, then we have on top a layer of green leaves, 4 or 5 leaves. And yeah, this is it. This is a leaf dress and now you can see my mom making it out of green satin fabric. And she has started with making the top of the dress and right now you can see her mastering her leaf making skills. We have seen it already one time in my Princess Tiana video. That outfit was just, I don't know, mind-blowing masterpiece. And now we can see the next step in her leaf-making journey. And today she's using my dad's soldering tool because, you know, everything in your household can be used in doll making. And here is the finished outfit. It looks really super adorable and also very quality made. You can see this double-sided top, really nice. And the leaves are super cute. It's really a beautiful tiny outfit. And this is how it looks on a doll, really super. Now let's make all kinds of accessories for our Tinkerbell. I will start probably with her shoes because it's quite in my comfort zone. Tinkerbell wears green ballerina shoes with this white pom-poms on the top, on the front of them. And I think I can make it quite easily out of Warbler thermoplastic. You know, I warm all the details with my hair dryer. The plastic becomes soft and sticky. You have seen it many times on my channel. So I can form shoes out of it. And then I will let it cool down for a couple of minutes to become super hard plastic again. Then I paint the shoes with acrylics and I decorate them with green glitter. And I'm going to mix actually two colors of glitter. I think it might look kind of more interesting, more 3D. And when all this painting and glittering and varnishing is over, I glue these white balls to the shoes. So, and this is it, the shoes are finished and they look really good on the doll together with this outfit. Well, and I can say that this step is finished, and now let's make probably a pair of wings for her. I've sketched here the wings with these patterns, the same like in the movie, I've printed them, and now I will still protect it with tape. Okay, we're ready to go. I take this wire and I start kind of tracing all the lines with this wire. Then I fill it in with UV resin. And the smaller details I'm going to make out of a thinner wire. And when I'm happy with this pattern, I cure it with a LED lamp. Then I take these pearl sand powders and I rub them into the cured resin. And I will use green and blue powders for it. So then all this situation I cover with resin again, and we're actually almost there. I just want to apply another layer of the resin to another side of the wing. Now we can trim the edges. Yeah, and after this I have to make still three more wings. So here they are, all the wings details are finished, and now we can assemble the wings and attach them to the back. Oops guys, my camera battery was empty and I was so busy with the wings that I didn't even notice it. So, this is what was made. I've connected all the details with the same resin, you can see all these four details of the wings. And then I cut off the wire that was here and I attached a pin a little bit higher than this wire was, because otherwise the wings would be too high on the doll. In this situation I had to or make the pin higher or to make a hole on the doll's body lower. But to make the hole lower, you know, we would have to remake the dress or to make a hole in the dress. So, I removed the wire, I took a regular sewing pin, attached it between the wings, and I put a stick from a Q-tip on this needle. Then I covered it all nicely with the resin, and now it all feels really super strong and very, very functional. So, this is it. The wings are finished. I'm really happy about it. I've never used this technology, this technique to make doll wings. So, this is it. I'm very happy about it, and now let's move on. So, and now I still want to make two things that were not really in the movies, but I thought they would make the project much more interesting. So, and first of all, I want to make a vintage lamp for my Tinkerbell. For this, I'm taking this plastic tube. I think there was some glitter inside before or something like this. And I cut a part of this tube. Now I take the resin and I start filling in the tube with it, mixing the resin with a bunch of glow-in-the-dark butterflies. I've bought lots of glow-in-the-dark things lately, so you know you can expect more glow-in-the-dark dolls in the future, or at least some glow-in-the-dark details like today. Today we're going to make a mini lamp full with some glow-in-the-dark butterflies or moths, something like this. So, check it out, it looks already very interesting to me. So, now let's take this foam tube, cut two slices of it, and glue them to the top and to the bottom of the tube. Then I've got this thing, you know, Gigi Grant Monster High doll has it in her ponytail, and the Gigi makeover will be normally my next doll, or one of my next dolls that you will see. I've already started customizing her, so this pink thing was laying on my desk in front of my eyes for a couple of days. So I suddenly thought it would be just the perfect detail in our lamp making journey. So, first of all, I cut a half of this biggest ball and I glue it to the top of the lamp. Now I think we can paint it all with acrylics. Okay guys, we're getting somewhere. Now let's make a handle, or how do you call this thing you use to hold the lamp. And then I want to add also some decorations, like some maybe chains, stars, flowers, something like this, to make it all cute and interesting. On top of it, I had a couple of extra glow-in-the-dark butterflies, and we're done, I think, guys. Check it out. Check out our super cute lamp. I don't know, it's really adorable. I've never made anything like this, and I'm absolutely happy about it now. So, now to complete this project, I still want to make a flower chair for my Tinkerbell. I think it would look very cute if she sat in the middle of the flower with this lamp in her hand. I don't know, at least in my imagination, in my head, it all looks super stunning. So, let's start with making a lily flower out of Warbler thermoplastic, and then we're going to connect it together. But first of all, we have to shape the petals. As the base of my chair, I will use this empty Q-tips box, the top of it we can remove, and to the bottom of this packaging, I'm going to attach all the 6 warbler petals that we've just made. And all the stamens I will make out of sewing pins. Well, the way it looks makes me already very happy, guys. So now let's paint it with acrylics, trying to make it look like a real lily flower. And I don't know, guys, it's very difficult, of course, to judge your own work, but I absolutely love the way it looks. My husband thought I bought it in a shop. Very pretty, really. Now we still need to decorate the base of the chair, and for this I will use these glow-in-the-dark stones. I think green, yellow, and white would look the best together. And now let's glue them to the base of the chair. I don't know, it will probably not be even that much visible since this part is hidden under the petals, but I think it would be a very cool detail anyway. And this is it, guys, the flower chair is finished and I'm really proud about it. And you know, I was going to announce the end of the project, but we actually still have to style her hair. Anyway, this is not that difficult today. First of all, I'm going to make a bun. And then we'll style the bangs, you know, my favorite part. And I'm going to use this surgical tool today. I thought it might work really nice for styling bangs because you kind of can fix all the hair together and curl them. Yep, and I think it actually worked. Her hairstyle looks super cute, but I think I still want to add a flower to decorate the bun. And then, guys, we'll finally be able to call this makeover finished and take a look at the end result pictures. So, guys, and this is finally our finished Tinkerbell doll, and you know it's difficult even to describe how much I love her. Strangely enough, she looks even better in real life than she did before in my imagination when I was just planning this project. Also, making this flower chair was the best decision ever because she can sit on it in really very different ways, in different positions, and she can even stand on it if you kind of put it next to the wall. With some a little bit balancing, but she can easily stand on top of this flower, and this is also amazing. The glow in the dark effect is very soft, it's not that bright, it always looks more bright on pictures than in real life. All my glow in the dark pictures, these night pictures, they are not edited at all, and in real life this glow is less than you can see now on pictures. But anyway, it looks very good and it looks very special, and also her lamp is extremely cute. And you know, it really fits the character, even though I've invented it myself. So all in all, guys, I think this is one of my most favorite dolls ever. I didn't expect it to happen, but yeah, this is exactly how it feels right now. Also, I've decided to draw the lashes this time instead of attaching false lashes. I don't know, I'm suddenly more into drawing lashes lately after being a fan of falses for many years. I have no idea how long it will last. Maybe I will be back to false lashes very soon, who knows. But I just wanted to ask your opinion, like what kind of doll lashes do you prefer? False lashes or the drawn lashes like today? And I would really, really love to hear what you think about it. So, and this is it. This doll you can find now for 3 days on eBay for sale. The link is in the description box under this video, so please feel free to check it out if you're interested. So, guys, and that was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you've enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon in my new doll repaint video, normally in 2 weeks. Nowadays, all these projects are so big with lots of accessories, I just cannot finish them in a week. Sorry, guys. I know you have to wait for a long time. I also love uploading weekly. But yeah, with this huge project, like for example this one today, there was no way to finish the doll, the video, all this voiceover, pictures, everything just in 1 week. So, see you for sure in 2 weeks. Love you guys. Bye.